meat that are being meat at a go right now. Not too good actually.
Okay, what do you want to know? I come from family of nine. Now, how many still surviving? I have to go back to do the past one. My two brothers. Six of them. No, two sisters and two brothers. So, there are five of us. So, coming from a family of actually, in all of the end of the day, actually, seven more left consistent. Coming from a family of seven, I put it seven, and number six. Yeah. And, you know, when you're a child, that is coming from a big family, there's no such thing as special preference. I always get hand-me-down. I mean, but it's okay. I never complained about, you know, getting, you know, little siblings, clothing. That's all. Like, you know, look towards it because why? His elder brothers used it, you know, kind of thing. So, school was fun. I'm not what you call a brilliant student, like unlike some people around me. But you know, I was an above average student who just managed to survive 1 year after the next, you know.
Where did you go to school?
St. John's
Institute. St. John's?
So I enjoyed, in fact, I was in the first 3 years in LaSalle Brickfields, in LaSalle PJ Brickfields. LaSalle PJ, LaSalle, no Brickfields, sorry. And then went on to St. John's and then 4 onwards and finished 145. And thereafter, you know, went on to do some studies in accountancy.
Right.
And, I didn't complete it because I was called by God.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Well, my childhood years, the road that I kind of the one that I remember fondly of was Kinji Road. You know, that's where most of my years were spent. And really grew up there, good friends. And recently I met up with some of them. You know, after like, for some it's like 40 years, meeting about 40 years, and others about 20 over years. And it's fun, meeting my friends of the past. Both of them are married, having children, and here I'm married to church, you know, having so many children. Yeah, so, yeah, childhood was, I really enjoyed it. Then, of course, with regards to after schooling, during those years, I also was involved in theater. I was involved in theater. I was with the Selangor Philharmonic Society for several years, getting involved with acting, singing, and dancing. Now, can you believe that? But it was a short period of time. But during that process, those years, I really learned a lot. In terms of confidence and able to carry myself. And it helped me in my preparation for this explaining to me. I don't say too much about that, that was those years, but 1 year. Then, well, when I was in mainland, I was in Berlin banking. In the course of those years, it's actually during my theatre years, I met an accident. That accident was a turning point for my after a rehearsal of one of the productions, we were traveling back to traveling home from the MCA building, the particular area. And I'm coming now just came and smashed it. So my brother, myself and my good friend, all three of us in the car, all of us injured quite seriously. And I think for me my injuries are quite serious. All this was scratched went inside. So the doctor who actually was not on call that day, it just so happened, he said there was an urgency to get to the hospital. And he didn't know why. He just was not on call. And when I was checking for him in the TH, at that point in time in the night, this doctor felt the cat 3 times on his shoulder. Each time he turned, there was no one. The third time, like he was drawn like a magnet to the emergency. And this is, I was telling you, he's a medical doctor. I called him my father, like, you know, in the course of the kidney. The third time, what I need, and my eyes for that matter, eye alien. And 8 hours of therapy. I recovered, and I'm supposed to be in hospital for 1.5 months, according to him. Because he showed me even that, you know, the pictures and things before and after. Normally, what it is, when you're on call, every doctor will take a picture before and after. He says, mine is only when it doesn't have. Because it's not. But he decided, you know what, maybe he decided to look after you. And he really took good care. Like a father. And he says, God must love you. God must really care for you. Because it's impossible to live with this unit, to be discharged without serious injuries. But you were discharged within 2 weeks and went home. I was a one-eyed bandit. You know, the pirates of Penzance. You know, and also, I was involved in theater that, I had to wear my, literally I had to wear the Baha'i, what do you call it? And I call it that. One of the roles.
The eyepiece.
Yeah, I had to use that, you know. And it was amazing. I went back to complete my theatrical art survival that I was supposed to do. And after that, it was the end of my theatre days. Because during those, you know, short span of time, that accident, you know, in the course of my stay in hospital, that went on for a week. I heard God's voice so distinct, so clear. I don't know how to describe him.
Did you say anything particular? Words that we can understand?
Words that, you know, like Jim Brown, scientist, he calls you, you know, like an echo, you know. I don't know how to describe, because it's still, I can feel it, that experience. And, you know, he's in preschool. I must be all the things of imagination, because of injured and recovery, and I'm thinking about life and death, and all this is just a matter of time. But then he kept on coming. And then was a moment in the hospital also, I heard a voice of our lady. And she called me by her home name. I won't tell you what my home name is. But I thought it was her. I turned to see if it was someone else who already doesn't. Actually, he called me, he said, no. And it was, you know, the voice just calling me. And I felt, you know, being reassured, you know, like some power. Level. I don't know how to describe it, but that awesome feeling, you say, like, that mother was there, you know. And the word was just calling my name and nothing else. That's it. I believe it was only. Now people might just say, the mind was only in those days, when I was in hospital, it was all around. And when that moment, when he called her, I felt healed. So much of all that pain and everything that's just going away. And I went out to do it somewhere. So the first thing I did was my mother has always every good Catholic go to cemeteries and give an offering, offer for it, you know, funds and all that, because you know, the accident happened on St. Anthony's Day. I think I just discharged on St. Anthony's Day, Tuesday. So when and then again, forgot about everything, you know, forgot about even what God asked me to be a priest. I went back to my work, you know, and said, go to the family. And I just be part of my family that, like, loving son, like, not say I was really that loving, but a loving son doing what is needed. In the course of that, 82 accident took place. In 83 or 84, a family member of mine went through some difficult moments. And you know, it was like a relationship with him, husband and wife difficulties. During the course of it, you know, together and we all prayed about, you know, what can be done. I was seated in the family hall with the whole family all gathered. And I was struggling with joy. What's happening here? My family member is having a serious problem. I'm bubbling with joy. I said, Lord, what's wrong with me? I should be not sad, you know, for what's happening here. And I'm very upset with the whole situation. And again, then when he said, I said, what? You know, I want to be my priest. I just stupefied. I said, are you real? I said, what about my family problem? It will be taken care of. I will look after them. because I've never been to outside Sunday going, you know, I've never gone to weekdays and going to Sunday and going to anything. I think Friday being something
here.
trip was good emotions and all that stuff. He, you know, the accident brought like a roundabout turn around to become a right of God. You know, like till today I have my injuries, I cannot see in the light clearly with the left eye. Because of the reason, and there's always this smile. But I'm not complaining about it. It's a reminder, you know, God's love. You see all that God's love for me. So I said, oh, you love me, you care for me. Now I want to respond to you the same way I care for others. And I said, I know. I remember when I was at seminary, because my father needed to ask us to write our call, you know. Why do you want to become a priest? I wrote the shortest, very short, because I said, I didn't write, well, I want to become a priest, I want to serve the poor. I said, I want to become a priest only because God cared for me and I want to do the same. I said, become like, I want to care for all. I do not know how to give my life back to God, but to the priest. So, that was the point. Then I started my seminary, but it's not smooth sailing. The seminary, when I, my impression of the seminary was, wow, all holy men, the really must be so. But when you enter, you realize that you're just down close like everybody else. You can, they can get on your nerves, they can get on their nerves, you can, you know. They have the normal everyday situations, like, we're not scared. Suddenly, you know, the world out there, even young boys and girls, they go, you're protected by God. You know, we have to face everything. And I remember Archbishop Trotter telling me, or telling all of us, if you can survive the seminary, you can survive anywhere. So, I do. Today, we have survivors. The formation of the human brothers. And that part of the story. So today, we ask me why I want to remain a priest. Because God loves me. And His care for me is beyond measure. I cannot even give back what I'm doing. You know, that's the what I'm doing. I'm trying my best. I know I have my limitations. I have weaknesses. I'm perfect. But I'm sure I'm giving my best. I believe that God is pleased. I'm not a man who's pleased enough now, but I know that God is pleased with what I'm doing, giving myself to God. So, yeah, and it also with my family generally, you know, my family was supportive. I tell you, my family is true. The joy of becoming a priest because my family was with me all the time. Mom and dad, siblings, even those in-laws came along to me. My nieces and nephews, I think, it was the end of that moment, yeah, their pride and joy. I also my pride and joy to see my family journey together. And to be a patient, when you have family, it's imperfect, but striving to do what is right, to find the good end. So I'm very happy being here. All the challenges, and all the ups and downs, I'm happy to be.
What's your favorite movie?
Sound of Music.
Sound of Music. Favorite movie in the past 5 years?
It will still be Sound of Music. But any space movie, my favorite movie, especially like Avengers.
A book you plan on reading?
Never thought of it before. Okay. Too much to handle at the moment.
Too much to handle at the moment. Favorite TV show that's currently on?
I hardly watch television.
Oh, okay.
I can't think of any. But if I think of something of the past,
yes.
Okay?
Yes, yes.
Brady Bunch.
Brady Bunch.
Little House on the Prairie.
Okay. On a scale of 1 to 10, how excited are you about life right now?
Oh, okay. I think I would put 8 to 9.
What's your favorite food?
Anything to do with prawns.
Least favorite food?
Ooh, anything is too chilly. And ikan kembung, keep away.
Keep away. What do you love on your pizza?
Pineapple, chicken, pepperoni.
Favorite dessert?
So many. If I look at the local dessert, I love chendol. If I look at the other kind of desserts. I cannot think.
Dark chocolate or milk chocolate?
Chocolate. But I'm allergic, I mean, I have problems with milk.
Okay. Are you lactose intolerant?
Yes, okay. But I still love milk chocolate.
Milk chocolate. Coffee or tea?
Tea, obviously.
What's the hardest part about being a priest?
I think that the moment when you celebrate such big occasions like Christmas and Easter and everyone going back to their family, going back home, sometimes being alone, sometimes praying alone also can be not easy. I like praying in community. But sometimes, not in all the things, but
what's your favorite band?
Out of My Mind comes now, ABBA.
ABBA, okay. Favorite solo artist?
Oh, I've got a few actually.
Okay.
Cliff Richard, Neil Diamond, and Andrew Company.
Favorite song?
What I always love to sing is You Raise Me.
If you could sing a duet with anyone, who would it be?
Celine Dion.
If you could master one instrument, what would it be?
Violin.
To be or not to be?
To be.
Dogs or cats?
Preferably dogs.
Best gift you've ever received?
The priesthood.
Best gift you were ever given?
Myself? If not, my theme of my gift to God, God of peace, make me a gift for others. So, in that context, I'm giving up. But the best gift I've given, I think, would be my the little ones of my family, you know, myself. I mean, I think that it's not about what do you call money, but the presence, you know, being there, you know, being available. That's one thing.
What is your favorite country to visit?
I love Ireland because I studied there. So, I never really thought of my favorite country, but.
Any you wish to visit?
If I wish to visit Switzerland.
Okay. What's the last country you visited?
Singapore.
Okay. What's your favorite color?
Blue.
Blue. What's least favorite color?
I think black.
Best way to de-stress?
De-stress. Going for a movie.
Movie? Okay. As in a theater?
Yes.
Movies? Okay. Wow.
And also, you know, like, last time I was playing on the organ. Because, you know, it's like creating compositions, things like that. So I
write music. Great music, wow. Okay.
But today it's like too much of a time. So movies is the way to relax.
Okay, what kind of popcorn do you like with the movie? Caramel? Okay. If you had one superpower, what would it be?
Healing.
Okay. What's the weirdest word in the English language?
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Do you like your handwriting?
I'm okay. I don't think I've got the best handwriting, but I thank God that I can write.
You can write. Okay. What's a sport you wish you could play?
That I wish I could play. Let me say that means not played before.
No, like you wish you could play like professionally.
Oh, professionally. I think it would be professional. Tennis.
Tennis. Scary film or happy endings?
Happy endings.
Three people alive or dead that you would like to have dinner with? Three people. Alive or dead?
I mean, I think if anyone like my mom, my dad, and any of my siblings.
Siblings. Rolling Stones or the Beatles?
Beatles.
Where were you born?
From the slang.
What is the farthest you've been away from home?
Ireland.
Sweet or savory?
Oh, that's a blend of both actually.
Blend of both, yeah.
I love sweet, I love savory. But if you put on the scale, I think sweet takes
over, yeah.
Takes control.
Takes over, yeah. What book have you read again and again?
I think it was Dan Brown's, what do you call that?
Da Vinci Code. Because of its...
Oh, you know, of course, it came out, you know, so I just read, you know, once too. I just read it again. I said it was so exciting because the suspense that was there, each time I read the second or third, you begin to appreciate it even more. You know? But of course, I'm not saying more to the person behind it. It was an exciting book to me.
It's an exciting book. Okay. Favorite bedtime story? Do you remember?
Bedtime story. Anything that was, I don't know whether my mom read me bedtime stories. If anything she would have read, if anything would be about Bible, children's Bible story.
Nice. What would be the title of your autobiography?
Planet.
Okay. Favorite animal?
Favorite animal. Never thought of it, but if any favorite animal, if I wanted to have a pet, what would it be? Tiger, lion.
You have a
favorite. I think in the day I would, would be a dog.
A dog. What is the best thing that happened to you this month?
Well, one thing I think of is, you know, for me, it's church related to Corpus Christi. The joy of going to the procession, there were so many following, and witnessing God and the story. That was the best thing.
And so many people around watching us as well. What is something that recently moved you?
Recently, I've got to think. Well, if anything that I appreciate or don't appreciate is, you know, the fact that the community that I have here at St. John's, and I visit the homes especially, I recently had every month I take appointments to visit homes, and how they're so, you know, welcome, come, well, you know, like the joy of seeing a priest, you know, and, you know, they're giving their best to you, you know, that's really appreciated. Really, I'm taken up by that. You see, I'm moved, perhaps, yes, I really appreciate it, you know, that there's still much respect for the priest and the priesthood, and, you know, opening your house to welcome the priest. And the last month would be that also. A new BC that was formed in Elements,
yeah.
I don't know where the place is, but you know, when I'm saying this, but so when you know, they call for a new, and about together with 15 of them were present. It was something really fantastic for me, and I was glad.
If you could teach one subject in school, what would it be?
I love history.
Oh, okay. What's your favorite birthday cake or flavor?
What I really like is, keep forgetting the name, Ramen.
Ramen raisins?
Ramen, something,
what?
Sujiki?
Sujiki?
No, Ramen, I think that.
Ramen raisins.
Ramen raisins.
Ramen raisin cakes.
Black, no, what do you call?
Black Forest.
Black Forest.
Oh, okay.
That's the one.
The one with the ramen. What's the one thing you still have from your childhood?
My memories.
What is one habit you wish you could break?
break, huh?
Yeah.
We should take a break, yeah. I think maybe my laziness. Sometimes you know, just to you know, get out of bed, yeah. It takes a little longer in a week that to break that, you know, I just can, you know, the bell, the alarm goes, come, I can come out. I just wait for the next to snooze, you know.
What makes you laugh no matter what?
Oh, wow. What makes me laugh no matter what? Well, I guess sometimes when I'm doing some work and I think of something hilarious, I just crack up.
Okay. You know? What are your favorite lyrics of all time?
Lyrics? I think without realizing it, I've been singing this, humming this all the time without realizing. We say this very true, maybe it is, you know, this particular church hymn, you know, what do you call it? See, now, he was saying it just the other day, and see, now it doesn't come to my mind. See, I cannot think of it. Jesus, my Lord, my God. Every day, suddenly, this comes to me. You know? So, I guess it has to be my favorite lyrics. Like, you know, I'll be singing it on and off over and over again.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
You ask me something secular, something secular would be the most.
What is something you've always wanted to try but you've been too scared to do?
Bungee jumping.
Okay, what advice for your 19 year old self?
I would have advised, looking at my friend, to be more responsible, to be more family oriented, and not to consider what you want to do in the future, because at that point in time I just...
Okay, like most people.
Yes.
Yeah. What did you want to do with your life at 12?
Oh, at 12, I remember putting in my report, I wanted to be three things. Mostly before that, first choice to be a pilot, second choice to be a judge, third choice to be a priest.
Oh.
So God took a third to make a person.
Okay. What is one goal you are determined to achieve in your lifetime?
Building BEC. I mean, well, besides that, goal to achieve, for me, actually, two of this. What is God's will, and how can I fulfill that? Whether you know it's successful or not doesn't matter, but faithfulness to it all the way. That's my
favorite Disney animal.
Oh, favorite Disney animal. Of course, obviously, I would say one day Donald Duck. Later movies, there was this character from. Beauty and the Beast. The character I like is Chip.
The little cup. Okay, favorite character from Star Wars.
It's not animal, isn't it?
No, but it's fine. What's favorite character from Star Wars?
Han Solo.
Han Solo, okay. What do you do on a rainy day?
I sleep. If I can.
What was your worst subject in school?
Oh, okay, science.
Any celebrity character you admire?
Celebrity character? The character in the movies? Yes, surely. Captain Kirk. And Han Solo. I would look at what the plans of the Archdiocese will be. Looking at, for my family will still always be building basic activities, BCs, and hoping that young and old alike will find the grace to recognize the importance of building relationship, you know, in all our structures. Not so much just the structure alone, but I think building relationship, we are all so unique, so special, so different, and yet there's so many similarities, and I think God's calling us to complement one another and build relationships. I mean,
relationship association. You can have all the projects and plans, you can be successful with the plan, but there's no building of people. There's nothing in play.
Thank you. Done.